Hey there, it's Ashley from Neauveau Fiber Arts, and I got a request to show a tutorial on how to make a braided roving. After you dye roving, which is wool that's been processed for yarn, it usually looks like this. Just fluffy, ready to spin or felt. And once you braid it, it looks like this. And this is a really easy way for you to wrap it and photograph it for all of your customers to see all the colors you have, or even display it yourself in your house, or kind of put it in bins where you can tell what color is what. So I'm going to show you how to do this really easily. So take your regular roving that's dry. Wool is dry when it no longer feels cool to the touch. You want to make sure that it's completely dry all the way through, because if you braid roving and it's still wet, it's possible that the fibers will get kind of tight and locked in. They won't be able to dry fully, and then they may end up smelling bad and getting mildewy. So make sure your roving is completely dry. Get to your beginning and make a slip knot. It's the exact same thing you do when you start a knit project or a crochet project, or you put a leader thread on your wheel. So I found that every single beginning of knit, crochet, and spinning begins with a slip knot. I'm sure that means something. So once you have your slip knot, you're going to take the roving and bring it through and keep it nice and loose. So then bring it through again, and you're basically making a single crochet chain. Mine has twists in it, so I like to get those twists out before I loop it. Okay, and now we're at the end. Got a little twig on there. So you can take the end and bring it through. And now it's braided. And it's really easy to roll this up. And there's the finished product. So that's how I like to braid my rovings. And if you're in the market for wool roving, you can find lots of unique colors in my Etsy shop, which is spinningbee.etsy.com. Thanks for watching.